Myself, Amit Kumar Ghosh, one of the senior scientists of Birbal Sahni Institute of Paleosciences, would like to introduce something about the Institute's history. The Institute was a dream of the eminent paleobotanist of the world, Professor Birbal Sahni. The desire of Professor Birbal Sahni, Fellow of Royal Society, the eminent paleobotanist, was to put paleobotanical research in India on an organized basis. As early as in 1929, he decided to establish a museum of fossil plants. Due to lack of response from the then government to grant funds for this venture, committed as he was, he resolved to see his cherished dream through the financing it from his own as well as from other private sources. In September 1939, Professor Sahni convened a meeting of Indian paleobotanists to coordinate paleobotanical research in India and also to publish periodic reports on the progress of Indian paleobotany to impart a formal status to the committee. In view of this, the Paleobotanical Society was founded on May 19, 1946, and registered as a trust on June 3, 1946. At Professor Sahni's behest, the governing body of the society resolved on September 10, 1946, to establish an Institute of Paleobotany. The institute started functioning at Birbal Botany Department of Lucknow University with Professor Sahni as the honorary director. Stone of the institute was laid down on 3rd April 1949 and it was prepared by Professor Sahni. It consists of 77 samples of plant fossils from all over the world embedded in a block of colored cement. The foundation stone is still in the museum of Birbal Sahni Institute of Paleosciences. Its size is 4 into 3 feet. The oldest of these fossils is an algal limestones from the Precambrian of Kadapa, South India, and the youngest one is a sample of charred rice grains recovered from Rohtak in Punjab, India. Unfortunately, after 3rd April, when the foundation stone was laid down, on 10th April in the same year, Professor Birbal Sahni expired, and it was a great loss for the nation as well as for the paleobotany. The Paleobotanical Society after that reconstituted itself as a purely professional scientific body and transferred the position of the institute to the newly constituted Birbal Sahni Institute of Paleobotany in November 1969. Under the new setup, the institute functions as an autonomous research organization financed by the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. In recent years, the institute has been renamed as Birbal Sahni Institute of Paleosciences to include the allied subjects as well as to expand its scope of research, and due to this, presently the institute is known as Birbal Sahni Institute of Paleosciences, and Dr. Vandana Prasad is the present director of the institute. The institute is still preserving the old memories or the pleasant memories of the founder. You can see Professor Birbal Sahni's father and mother, Mr. Ruchiram Sahani, and the photograph is here. And you can see the initial building of Birbal Sahni Institute of Paleosciences, which was that at that time known as Birbal Sahni Institute of Paleobotany. Here in the bottom, you can see the old building of the institute, and the stone petrified wood of Orokaryoxylon is preserved over here, and it is still maintaining its legacy because the stone is or the petrified fossil is still there. Now coming to the old establishment, that is the botany department. you can have the same look of the botany department of Lucknow University, which is situated in a different campus. And here in the bottom you can see the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru is laying down the foundation stone that consists of 77 fossil samples, and the oldest one is from the Precambrian of Kadapa Basin, and the most recent one is from the Rohtak, Punjab. Here you will find the instruments, those are using at that time by Professor Birbal Sahni. This is the old microscope. It is still as it is. And by this microscope, he published the world-class research papers. You can imagine at present at what capacity we are working. You can see here the machines which were used by him. Here it is a simple saw by which the petrified woods were cut and thin sections were prepared. Nowadays, very sophisticated instruments are there, but at that time, with this saw, he used to cut the rocks and prepare the slides out of it. Here you will find his apron, which was used by him along with the pen used by him. Now coming here, the old telephone. It is still here. The lamp, the table lamp, it is still here. The paint stand, the stamp holder, everything we are preserving along with the handwritings of Professor Birbal Sahni, the corrected manuscripts. Now you see, we are using nowadays computers, but at that time this was the typewriter by which the manuscripts are written or for sending it to journals. And this is the way he started the institute, and where we have reached, you can remember, we are in the climax at present. Here you will find the camera, the field camera as well as the microscopic camera by which the photographs were taken by Professor Sahni, the bags which are used in the field by him for field, and some of the literatures which are preserved over here. So this is the initiation of paleobotanical research in India, and we are still maintaining the legacy of Professor Birbal Sahni to establish this science of paleosciences in India, as well as to popularize and disseminate this knowledge throughout the world.